Hello all, I am Mr. Lee, Chemsir. This video clip is to discuss with you all the answers in the test on redox reactions and chemical cells. Let's discuss the questions one by one. MC questions first. Question number one. First of all, make sure you know that this is what we called a complex. Complex. Its structure is like this. Actually, there are two kinds of species, ammonia molecule and chloride ions, bonded to this cobalt, CO. The structure of this complex may be like this. Actually, there can be other possible structures. Make sure you know that this is really an ammonia molecule. So the oxidation number of this part, I mean the sum, should be zero for ammonia. And this one is the chloride ion. So the oxidation number of chlorine is negative one. So the oxidation number of cobalt here is positive two. So this is actually a cobalt two ion. The answer is B. Question number two. These three species were arranged according to the increasing order of oxidation number of chlorine. So first of all, in HCl, the oxidation number of chlorine is negative one. In HClO3, the oxidation number of chlorine is positive five. How about the four options? I think you all can work well. So these are the oxidation numbers. So obviously, B is the answer. Question number three. This is an unfamiliar situation. First of all, this part from iodide to iodine is familiar to you, right? So you should be able to balance this half equation so quickly, like this. How about the other half equation? VO2 plus becoming VO2 plus. Although it is unfamiliar, you just make use of what you learned before. So add 1H2O on the right first, and then you add 2H plus. On the left, and then you need to add one electron to balance the half equation. Oh, from the question, the unknowns are here, x, y, and z here. Of course, x is also here. So, refer to the half equation we just got. These are the coefficients. For the time being, this is 1 to 2 to 1, right? However, when you judge from the number of electrons in each half equation, you need to know that you need to multiply this half equation by 2 in order to write the overall equation. So after multiplying by 2, these three coefficients will become 2, 4, and 2. So the answer is C. Page 2. Which of the following is not a redox reaction? Not a redox. Of course, we try to calculate all the oxidation numbers involved. Silver, there is a change. Bromine, there is a change. So this is a redox reaction. In option B, sulfur from positive 4 to 0, and also from negative 2 to 0. This is again a redox. Option C, KClO3, the Cl, has the oxidation number positive 5. It becomes KCl, the oxidation number of Cl being negative 1. Of course, for oxygen, oxidation number changes from negative 2 to 0. So all these three are redox. Actually, the answer is D. D is not a redox reaction. You may have some checking, and then you will find that the oxidation number of carbon remains positive 4. Of course, for calcium, positive 2. Question number 5. Again, this is an unfamiliar situation. Anyway, from iodide to iodine, this is of course an oxidation. Which substance brings about oxidation of iodide to iodine? Of course, that is oxygen, being the OA, oxidizing agent. Why? It is because the change in oxidation number of O is from 0 to negative 2. Therefore, option 1 is correct. Option 2 is incorrect because carbon dioxide is not the oxidizing agent. And then for option 3, the yellow color of course comes from iodine. Normally it is brown, but when the concentration is not that high, it is yellow. So this is incorrect. Instead, it comes from iodine. So this is incorrect. So the answer is A. Question number 6. Redox reaction. First of all, option 1 is just a mixing process. There is no reaction between methanol and ethanol. Option 2, chlorine reacting with methane. Let's consider the mono substitution, okay? You know, this reaction can be a chain reaction. If we just consider the mono substitution, chlorine reacting with methane, then the product will be CH3Cl and HCl. From this, we can find the oxidation number of Cl. There is a change. For carbon, before the reaction, oxidation number of carbon is negative 4. After the reaction, it is negative 2 because, you know, hydrogen, the oxidation number is always positive 1. So, option 2 is correct. Option 3, ethene reacting with acidified potassium permanganate solution. So, you learned this reaction in book 2 already. Ethene, oxidizing agent, will provide oxygen like this. When we have to balance the equation, then this reaction will give a diol like this. So this oxygen comes from the permanganate. Although permanganate ion did not appear in this equation, we all know that the mixture becomes turns from purple to colorless because of this change. So, this is again a redox. So, the answer is C. Section B, structured questions. Number one, this is so obvious. 1B, environmental impact. Make sure you know that when the question talks about this, it is usually referring to pollution or some hazards to living things. So what you are expected to answer is the hazard of the species involved. Page 3. Question number 2A is very straightforward. Actually, during lessons, I train you a lot. So I suggest not to discuss it in details. Instead, I spend more time on B. This is unfamiliar. Hydrogen peroxide solution oxidizes potassium iodide solution. So First of all, you need to know that iodide becoming iodine is familiar to you. Let us write the equation first. Iodide becoming iodine. How about the hydrogen peroxide, H2O2? It is the oxidizing agent. The point is, what will it be reduced to? Check from its oxidation number, O being negative 1. If it is to be reduced, the O will probably become 0 or negative 2. What do you think? Yes, should be negative 2. So H2O2 will become H2O. So this is your thinking process. So hydrogen peroxide will be reduced to H2O because it has a change in oxidation number, the decrease in oxidation number. So let's go on with the half equation method. You write the 2 here, balancing the number of O, and then you should add 2H plus on the left, and then balance the half equation, adding 2 electrons like this. You simply add these 2 together, and you get this overall equation. The observation is straightforward, okay? Question number 3. This reaction should have been discussed in book 2, in the topic air pollution. Just to remind you, the 2, the coefficient 2 here. Part B, meaning of the term disproportionation. When I marked your papers, I found that quite a number of you could not write the word species. Let me tell you, okay? If you write element here, it is an incorrect idea. If you write compound here, it is also an incorrect idea. If you write substance here, I think the idea is actually not good or not good enough, although it is acceptable. Because species may mean a substance and sometimes an ion. You know, for example, permanganate ion, dichromate ion, they may act as oxidizing agent. And in some cases, certain species may be an ion that may undergo the disproportionation. So make sure you know that species is the best word, best term. And that's why your textbook uses this term, species. So I don't suggest you to write all these because they are incorrect ideas. And then the part 2, 2 marks, okay? 2 marks. The first mark go to, okay? You mentioned the change in oxidation number of N from positive 4. And then the other one mark will go to the 2 resulting oxidation numbers. Finally, the question number 4. This is a simple chemical cell consisting of 2 different metals. Of course, zinc is more reactive. So it will be the negative electrode. Lead is the positive electrode. Direction of electron flow. This is very straightforward. I think no need to discuss it further. Why the lemon juice can conduct electricity? This is the best answer. They are mobile ions. Of course, you may say that lemon juice is an electrolyte. Lemon juice is an electrolyte. This is not good enough, actually. Why an electrolyte can conduct electricity? It is due to the presence of mobile ions. So mobile ions is the best answer. Positive electrode is the lead, okay? Lead. Therefore, cations will migrate towards the positive electrolyte. In this case, should be the H plus. H plus becoming H2. Finally, what if lead is replaced by copper? How will it affect the voltage? So this depends on the difference in the tendency to lose electrons for the 2 metals involved. So recall the metal reactivity series, zinc, and then, of course, iron, and then lead. So the difference in the tendency to lose electrons is like this. If lead is to be replaced by copper, copper is here, then there is a larger difference in the tendency to lose electrons. Larger difference that results an increasing voltage, okay, or the voltage become higher or becoming more positive. So thank you for watching the video clip. Hope you got all the answers and hope you got all the correct ideas behind the questions.